obviously I'm in the same boat as everyone else currently, inside, hashtag lockdown. So there's no chance we can be going to pubs rating Guinness. So I said, I'll go to O'Brien's, bought a heap of different stuff. Me and Cozy were like, oh, should we do like porters 1 week and IPAs the next? I don't know what we're gonna do, but basically I just went and just grabbed. I never knew there was so much of a choice in O'Brien's until I went down and looked at all the different things, like all these IPAs, craft beers, porters, stouts, ciders. I grabbed about 10 different things. I didn't even really look at what they were. But obviously, first home review of this whole lockdown period. We're gonna keep our country, we're gonna keep our locals, stick to what we know-ish. So Guinness Original Stout. Focus to fuck. I don't think I've tried this before. I've tried the Guinness XX, which I thought tasted like arse. That was the one that was like, this is how Guinness tasted 200 years ago or whatever it was. So we've got a big ass bottle here, 568 mils, alcohol level 4.2%. I actually looked up like some of these craft beer reviews and stuff before I did this to try make it sound like I knew what I was talking about. Now obviously in terms of Guinness, I don't think there's gonna be a whole lot to know, but yeah, look, let's crack her open and give her a go. Extra stout, original recipe, dark and lively. Okay. As well, like, I don't know, is it supposed to go into a full Guinness glass? It's the 568 mils, that's a pint, so, isn't it? Yeah, that's a pint, so I'm gonna make the pint and see what happens. Whoosh, oh yeah. Like, I presume there's gonna be no head, so I don't think there's gonna be much pressure on the pour. Let's have a go. Oh yeah, this. Again, same as the extra stout or the XX before. Looks like Coca-Cola. I presume it'll make a full pint. Looks like it could do more than a full pint, to be fair. We'll take our handy bite. Ah, Jesus. Yeah, it looks very similar to the Guinness XX. Let her settle down. We might as well pour a full pint so I can at least pretend I'm in the pub. Alright, that'll do. Wait. Looks pretty dark. Can't really see through it. The colour of it, to be fair, is fairly in line with the colour of Guinness, but it doesn't really like, it's just a bit more watery. It's not as thick as a good pint of Guinness. Right, I'll fill it up all the way, sure, for the crack. For the absolute mayhem carnage crack that we're having. There you go, nice full pint. Are you supposed to smell it when you do these things? I don't know. It doesn't smell that bad. It smells just like watered down Guinness, but extra stout, I suppose, like, it's the same percent as Guinness, so I presume it's gonna be extra stout, like there's more stout in it. I don't know. I've never pretended to be an expert with these things. I like to think I kinda know what I'm talking about when it comes to pints of Guinness, but as for everything else, I know just as much as you, but sure, a bit of crack to review. There we go, rhyming it up, let's go. It's not awful now, to be fair. I don't think there's gonna be much of a shtick calculator to be going on, but it's not awful. I remember the first time I tasted the Guinness XX and the foreign extra. I literally thought, holy shit, I can't take another mouthful. But it's okay, you know, in terms of stuff you're gonna have to drink at home. I know some lads just like that bit of an extra dirty Guinness taste, and I presume this is who that's for, because obviously they sell a lot of it. I have another swig, but yeah, it's not too bad now. I suppose you could compare it to when you're a young lad and you have your first Guinness and you think, geez, that is septic, and then you kind of get used to it. I can kind of see that happening with this. It's the second mouthful was actually better than the first, so I don't know, we'll have another swig. Yeah, shtick is going to be 0 out of 10. Oh, serious shtick. Oh, yeah. But yeah, you wouldn't be expecting a shtick. Right, give me one sec, I'll give another sip, and then I'll give it a score. I'm not gonna drink this, I'm not gonna score this as if it's a pint of Guinness from a pub, so I'll be, I guess out of 10, I'll be a bit more lenient. But one more sip. Drink it too fast to get the hiccups and then you can't give a proper score. And the burps come like 3, 2, 1. No. There we go. Right, one more swig. One thing I would definitely say is you wouldn't drink that as fast as a pint of Guinness because it's very, it's quite carbonated. A lot of carbonation going on there. Do you know what I mean? So it's pretty fizzy and it's just not, that doesn't have that thick creamy taste. Yeah, it's, wouldn't be my absolute cup of tea. But again, if you're stuck at home, you're stranded, I'd definitely drink one or two more. I'm gonna go nice little 6.3. Not an awful score, but yeah, Guinness Extra Stout, dark and lively, 6.3 out of 10 from the Guru. But yeah, anyway, lads, that's today's review from The Gaff. Stay safe, and we'll see you again soon. Telling me just what you want.